This is my camera comparison test of the new Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra versus last year's S23 Ultra. Which one is best, or should you upgrade? Let's find out.
You'll be surprised that there's some bigger camera differences here than you might think. And no, this video's not sponsored. I had to buy these expensive suckers myself. So I'm gonna be brutally honest with you guys. Should you save your money? I'm gonna show you guys photo and video comparisons, daytime and nighttime. We'll see if that new 50 megapixel 5X tele lens on the new S24 Ultra, is it better or worse? And then how about slow motion and stabilization and a ton more? Jumping right into the daytime photos, a few things you should notice. First, how insane and fun is it that we can be standing so far away from something like this billboard sign? And let's say I really want to lose some weight fast so I could read that website and drop those pounds. Second, when comparing the ultra-wide 0.X lens to the 1, 2, and 3X range, all of them should look pretty similar in terms of clarity, colors, and then maybe slightly different in the processing. But then when we hit that 5 to 9X range, that's where we sort of see that new 50 megapixel 5X optical lens on the S24 Ultra, it's looking quite a bit sharper. Then anything after that 10X range, well, they exchange blows, and it's the older S23 Ultra's 10X optical lens. Even though it has less megapixels, it churns out stronger on that far end of the zoom. And this whole camera comparison test is perfect for two groups of people. A, is it worth the upgrade? Or B, can you save a lot of money and maybe go with the S23 Ultra for a just as good phone? And the price difference is pretty massive. The S24 Ultra is insane, up at $1,300, while the S23 Ultra, renewed on Amazon, is almost half the price. I found them in that $700 to $800-ish range. Snapping a couple selfie portrait shots, and I noticed the S23 looks a bit more greenish in my face tones, and then the S24 is a bit more warm or red, which I think is a bit more realistic in these shots. Also notice that edge cutout. While they were very close tie, there's a few times that the S24 does a better job over the S23. Both cameras capture these vibrant looking macro shots, which I always find they're crazy impressive and fun to play around with. In low light, we have some super interesting results, as the 0.6 and the 1X look almost exactly the same. But then, very oddly, the S23 produces a much cleaner, sharper looking 3X photo. Then at 5X, it makes sense that the new S24 takes a much nicer looking shot. And then at the 10X, it's almost a tie. What do you guys think? Both of them are pretty sharp and solid looking. Outside nighttime shots, interesting to see how the processing of white balance is different. It's a bit more orangey on the S24, even though stars are looking a bit better on the S23, I'd vote. And then the S24 has the splotchy yellow circles up in the sky. Now, I bet you don't know about this hidden Easter egg trick in expert raw mode. There's astrophoto. Shout out to this guy Jason for the tip. There's a sweet constellation overlay, and you can select a long exposure duration of 4, 7, or 10 minutes, and the final shots are pretty awesome. I'd love to try this in a better location with less light pollution. Now let's run some video tests, and there's a few more unique differences you probably don't know. On the front-facing camera video, we're seeing same color differences, more red on the left, more greenish on the right, same wobbly stabilization on both, great 4K sharpness like seen here in my jacket and beard.
This is a quick little audio test. I'm underneath the highway, so there's some loud background noise. Which audio sounds best, or do they sound the same?
Now, very interesting. Did you hear the difference? I'd say the S23 has a bit more wind rumbling noise that's more noticeable.
All right, I'm currently at this train museum, and this place is really cool. Let's go ahead and appreciate the insane zoom reach that we have on these both on both these cameras. Now, this is the ultra wide on both, so you can squeeze in a ton into frame, and it's a super impressive shot. Let's go ahead and start zooming in, 1x on each. Now this is the 3x, then 5, zoom into 5 on there. There you go. Then let's jump to 10, see that little tiny sign over there. 20x is the max reach. How insane is that? We could almost read that tiny text on that sign from all the way back here. So cool. What about zoom transition? Let's see if one is a little bit smoother than the other.
Are they the same?
I'd say the transitioning between lenses looks about the same. What do you guys think? I also wish it was a bit smoother like my iPhone, and if you didn't see that camera comparison test, check that one out after this one. Here's the One X primary 4K 30, and I'm seeing a lot more similarities than differences. Very similar looking dynamic range, same looking colors and clarity. Honestly, both of these cameras can shoot awesome looking video.
This is that SuperSteady stabilization mode on both of them, 0.6, the ultra wide lens. Can you tell any sort of difference? Did they make any sort of improvements here?
Unfortunately, I'm not seeing a big upgrade in this arena. So do you guys think we still need a GoPro for action camera shots? Make sure you're subscribed and come back for my in-depth camera comparison test. Now here's one major upgrade we now have on the S24 Ultra, and Samsung has removed that super slow-mo option, and instead of those short bursts of pixelated 960fps, we can capture 120fps in 4K resolution. Now it's no 240fps, but like seen here, I think I'll take that awesome resolution and clarity upgrade any day. It looks really good. One final video test, and check out the low light video on the ultra wide and primary 1X. They both look pretty sharp without terrible noise or grain. There's good highlight control as well, like seen in the RGB rope light and LED clock. Then check out this super interesting difference. Even though we have that longer reach, quote unquote, better periscope lens on the S23, it just goes to show that the new S24 optical lens, it has that larger aperture and possibly a better sensor, and it makes a massive difference here in low light video. Now besides all the camera differences, of course, there's a few other major differences you should know. The look and feel of the S24 Ultra, it's titanium, flat display on front with curved edges. It just feels very premium in the hand. That new display is really awesome. It's anti-reflective, it makes a massive difference, and it goes insanely bright up to 2600 peak nits. There's those AI features for photo editing or circle the search with Google Lens. It's incredibly useful and fun. Although I did read that it's coming to the older S23 Ultra in a future update. So honestly, of course, both of them are fantastic options, but if you need to save some money, maybe stick with the S23 Ultra. It's crazy how much you can save with just a 1-year-old device. Now, unless those new hardware changes seem like an awesome upgrade for you. Oh, and quick side note, I promise this isn't sponsored. These Ultra phones, they're just massive in hand, and I found this cool phone case that I thought you guys might like. It's got the spinning O-ring that works as a finger grip, plus a phone tripod, plus it has magnets for snapping onto my MagSafe stuff. I really like its diverse utility. Tora sent a few of these over for me to check out, and I think it's really cool, so I thought you might like it as well. Not sponsored, I promise. All links down below, and I'll see you guys in my next one.